super antigens. As the name suggests, that means that these antigens, which are more than or extra than the normal antigens, means they have an ability to activate the immune response in a hyper manner. Means ke normal immune response se zyada activation these antigens can have an ability to do it. Now, what kind of antigens these are? So, usually we have discussed that the antigens are T-dependent antigens. So, super antigen is also a variety of T-dependent antigens. Means, ke in antigens ko activation ke liye, immune system ki activation ke liye, T-cells ki help require hai. Means, the T-cells are mandatory for the activation of immune response for such kind of antigens. And what happened that these conventionally, if you can see that, the T-dependent antigens, they have an ability to activate the T-cells in a small fraction. Means, unka kuch small number activate kar sakti hai. Normally, jo normal antigens hain, jo ke T-cell dependent antigens hain. But in this case, in super antigens, they can activate 25% of T-cells. Not in a polyclonal manner. Polyclonal means that the different clones, so many clones of T cells can be activated. How they can act? So you can see that hyperactivation of the T cells by the super antigens. So is figure mein, agar aap dekhen, so here there is another comparison. So in the left panel, there is the conventional antigens, means conventional antigens jo ke T cell dependent hain, but in a conventional way, they have the ability to activate the T cells in a monoclonal or oligoclonal response. Mono means that single clone of T cells can be activated, or more than one or more than two clones if they are activated, those are called as oligoclonal. So in the left panel, you can see that ke center mein ek T cells, jo ke second hai, that is going to activate it by conventional antigens. Okay, that is conventional T cell dependent antigen. But on the other hand, in comparison with conventional, on the right panel you can see that super antigens. Now the super antigens, they are going to activate so many T cells. Means agar aap first row mein dekhen, to first row mein two T cells they are going to be activated, aur usse niche only one. And then in the last, there are also the two T cells, they are going to be activated. So that means that these cells, these antigens, they have an ability to activate the T cell in hyper manner. That's why these are called as super. Means ke they, these antigens are extra, you can say that, extra to normal activation. That's why these are hyper activation of the T cells. And similarly, they are activating the T cells not in a monoclonal or oligoclonal manner as compared to the conventional. In this case, in case of super antigens, these antigens, they are activating the T cells in polyclonal. Jaisa ki aap figure mein dekh sakte hain ke first row mein two T cells they are going to activate it, usse niche ek, aur isi tarah last mein also there are two T cells. So you can see that different clones, so many clones of the T cells, they are going to be activated. Ab in clones ne aage repertoire develop karne hai. So you can see that the T cell repertoires, T cell repertoires, they are going to be activated in a polyclonal manner. So super antigens are those antigens which have an ability to activate the T cell in hyper manner as compared to the conventional T cell dependent antigen. Now coming to the different examples that where these super antigens they are being present. For example, in case of bacteria, so there are so many bacterial antigens which has the ability to serve as super antigens. For example, in case of Staphylococcus aureus, that is the gram positive cocci, it has an ability to secrete a toxin that is called as enterotoxin. So that is called as staphylococcal enterotoxin, means enterotoxin that is specific to staph or staph aureus. So this antigens has a, or this toxin has an ability to cause food poisoning. So you can see that in case of food poisoning caused by staph aureus, there is the hyperactivation of the T cell. That's why there is a hyper immune response is going to be produced. Similarly, there are other bacterial antigens, for example, in case of Staph aureus, enterotoxins and exfoliating toxins, which is causing the scalded skin syndrome, and staphylococcal toxic shock toxin. These are also the important toxin which has the ability to cause toxic shock syndrome. So these are bacterial toxins which serve as a super antigen. So super antigens are not only limited to the bacteria, but these are also present in certain viruses as well as other microorganisms which can has the ability of acting like a super antigen. So super antigens are very, very important clinically in order to activate the immune system in a hyperactivated manner.